This is Tom Radke, and today I've got farm-raised eggs, I got Costco eggs, these are the cage-free eggs, then there's the generic cheap eggs. I'm gonna go over all the best tips and tricks for eggs. Are they healthy? Are they good for your heart? Do they raise your blood cholesterol? Do they get you jacked like a bodybuilder? What are the big mistakes people are making? We're going over all the myths, all the secrets, all the latest studies, and we're starting now. Who am I to talk to you about eggs? I've unfortunately had to do a lot of foot and ankle surgery on diabetes, people with metabolic disorders, and I'm talking like over 2,000 procedures, people losing toes, feet from metabolic disorders. And these are the myths that even blew my mind a little bit once I started getting deep down into the research, because I was wrong about some of this stuff too. So number one, are eggs good or bad for the heart? There's still some debate. Do they raise cholesterol levels? Should you avoid them or should you be eating like six a day?
Since the 1960s, we've been told that cholesterol is horrible for us and we can get heart attacks from eating too many eggs, that our arteries will fill up with fat and that will get plaque and cholesterol.
So when I look at the health statistics for three eggs, that's 561 milligrams of your daily cholesterol value. That's 15 grams of fat. So 23% of your daily fat. That's 4.8 grams of saturated fat. That's a quarter of your daily saturated fat. Here's the big scam. In 1961, there was a guy, Ansel Keys. He talked about saturated fats and dietary cholesterol. There are specific debates on how this was all corrupt studies that guided this country to adopt a high sugar, low fat diet. Specifically, the seven countries study. Ansel Keys conducted the famous seven countries study, which looked at the relationship between diet, lifestyle, cardiovascular disease in different countries. And critics said that Mr. Keys specifically ignored certain countries. So it's called the French paradox. Some countries that had high fat had more heart attacks, but France, they have a lot of cheese, a lot of fat, a lot of butter, and relatively low heart attacks. Hey, let's not include that as part of our seven countries. There's accusations of cherry picking of data. That data from certain countries did not align, and even beyond France, critics say that this was not proper. And what it always comes down to, a conflict of interest. Myth number one, eggs are bad for heart health due to cholesterol content. It has minimal impact on blood cholesterol levels for most people. And in fact, the highest level of study is a systematic review and meta-analysis of large-scale studies and double-blind studies. They looked at 17 different studies in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition in 2013 and found that consuming eggs does not have hardly any impact on blood cholesterol levels in individuals.
Eggs have as much cholesterol as a Big Mac, but they decrease cardiovascular disease. They decrease diabetes. They decrease cancer rates. You can't argue with these studies at this point.
Another study published in the Journal of Clinical Nutrition looked at a very large prospective cohort of studies and found that egg consumption lowers the risk of type 2 diabetes and arterial issues in people. Eggs need to be avoided by individuals with high blood pressure. This is false. Eggs have been concluded in a heart-healthy diet for individuals with high blood pressure. A study published in the Journal of Clinical Nutrition in 2016 analyzed data from the Framingham Heart Study and found no association with the consumption of eggs and developing high blood pressure.
So paradoxically, rather than causing heart attacks, eggs actually prevent heart attacks. So studies show this in population studies, not just bench studies. It will not clog up your arteries and it will not give you a heart attack.
Myth: eggs yolks should be avoided due to high cholesterol content. And while egg yolks do contain cholesterol, it is important that they are very high in all the good vitamins, minerals, and antioxidants.
We dispelled the cholesterol myth. So eat the yolk. That's where all the great vitamins and nutrition are hiding.
And this specifically, the egg yolks, has been shown in a Journal of the Academy of Nutrition Dietetics National Nutrition Examination Survey found that these did not have any increased risk in heart attacks, stroke in healthy adults. So the answer is cholesterol does not necessarily cause heart issues. And that's shown by the French paradox as well. And in fact, only 50% of heart attack victims have elevated cholesterol level. Something to think about. Studies now show that cholesterol itself may not be harmful. The problem happens when cholesterol becomes damaged or oxidized. So essentially, cholesterol particles exposed to free oxygen radicals, this is smoking, processed foods, sugar, this leads to plaque and atherosclerosis.
One thing I see in clinic a lot is these types of plaque blockages. This is really damage. This is a picture of oxidization and moving. It's kind of the rust, the damage that happens on pipes. Same thing happens in your heart, your legs. It narrows those blood vessels. The procedure back there is called an angioplasty with a stent. You can basically expand it, but it's impossible to roto-rooter those out.
And in fact, carnivore diet is very popular now, and some of these guys have been eating nothing but meat for like 5 to 10 years and are in excellent shape. They run triathlons, marathons, and lift weights every day. It's not just cholesterol. Another study showed that eggs actually increase your good cholesterol. So there's bad cholesterol, which is your very low density lipoprotein, and then there's good cholesterol, which is your HDL. Your HDL is your high density lipoprotein. This actually grabs the bad cholesterol and throws it out of your body. And eggs have the ability to increase your HDL.
Some cholesterol, like HDL, actually picks up the bad fat and damage in your body and it returns it to your liver. So your HDL in the top left corner is mostly protein. And you could see as it picks more up, it dumps it into the liver and other areas for processing. HDL picks up all that bad fat and damage and drops it up in the liver.
So what's the nutrition of an egg? This is really the good part. Eggs are known to be the number one superfood. They have a ton of protein. So protein is amino acids. They work with muscle strength, repairing your tissues. The average person is said to need 1 gram per kilogram, or about 0.5 gram per pound. So it's very important to get enough protein, and eggs are a good, healthy way of doing that.
Look at all the nutrition that eggs have. Pretty much every vitamin. They are a true superfood and not one to be ignored.
Eggs are high in monounsaturated fats. These are important for brain function, hormone absorption, absorption of fat-soluble vitamins, omega-3 fatty acids. They work on brain function and lowering inflammation and are actually shown to help with weight loss. So you get your minerals, which are iron, zinc, and selenium. It also helps with vitamin D3. So in the winter time, you get about 8.2 micrograms per egg, which is about 30% of your daily recommended amount. And you also get vitamin K2, which is very important for your teeth, for your bones, for limiting calcification in your arteries. Eggs can actually make your arteries healthier. Egg yolk contains between 67 and 192 micrograms of vitamin K2. Choline deficiencies can cause a lot of issues like fatty liver, kidney, pancreas, muscle deterioration, and they also contain vitamins A, D, E, K2 specifically, the B vitamins. Myth that egg yolks should be avoided is completely false. Studies show egg yolk is very healthy, and in fact, even the vitamin K2 and other nutrients can actually make your heart health stronger.
I believe the studies aren't conclusive, that eggs are not bad for your heart, and in fact, a lot of things like vitamin K2 in the eggs actually help your artery and heart dramatically.
1/3 of all adults around the world are said to be pre-diabetic now. Eggs actually decrease the risk of type 2 diabetes. Type 2 diabetes is associated with high heart and artery issues. Eggs decrease that, so another way eggs actually improve heart and artery health. Studies show that it decreases type 2 diabetes. Now, the two I'm holding here, this one's free range. It's actually on a farm. This is cage-free. So what's the difference between these? Should you spend the extra money on these when you go to Costco, or should you buy directly from a farmer, or can you get the cheap ones for like $1 for a dozen? Free-range chicken specifically has more vitamins and more omega-3 fatty acids. Overall, you're still getting a lot of good nutrition, even with the store-bought ones, but the farm-raised ones have a little bit more omega-3 fatty acids. Caged eggs are a little bit lower in omega-3 fatty acids, thus it doesn't help your inflammation as much. There was a study where free range versus commercial showed that the caged ones had much less omega-3 fatty acids. So this white one is store-bought, and this is the one I got from the farm. So realistically, the one from the farm is harder to crack, it's richer in yolk, has more omega-3, has more density, and has more shellfish. So the study also showed that the farm-raised one had 25% more vitamin E, 75% more beta carotene, and up to 20% more omega-3 fatty acids. This also goes for other farm-raised animals. So like grass-fed beef, a little bit lower in inflammation-causing compounds, higher in healthy fats. Brown eggs are more nutritious than white eggs. The answer is no. So generally the store-bought ones are white, and that makes the difference. But when you buy it off the farm, some can be white, some can be brown, and there's no real difference between the two. But there is a difference between the farm and the store. And all that's according to the Journal of Poultry Science in 2010 and 2015.
Another farm egg benefit is that they will keep for 2 weeks on your counter. You don't have to stuff your fridge full. So you could bulk buy a lot from the farm and they should last according to most studies.
Now the next step is, how do you cook these eggs? I know this is a mistake I was making in terms of health issues are, what do you cook them in? If you take a lot of canola oil or vegetable oil and pour it in there, that's where you're getting a lot of the bad fats, a lot of the bad oils. And that kind of mixes in with a tiny little egg that otherwise is just 75 calories. Seed oils are very controversial now. And what happens is, oxidation affects polyunsaturated oils more due to their chemical structure. This leads to increased inflammation. Specifically, these are soybean oil, corn oil, canola oil, sunflower oil, grapeseed oil.
Seed oils are tricky and controversial. I defer to Dr. Kate Shanahan. I really loved her chart and she summarizes it well here. There's bad fats and oils that you probably should not eat. Generally, if you focus to what's on the good fat and good list here, these tend to work out much better for you. This is a great list that I tend to follow. I'm not gonna deep dive into each one.
It is possible to cook eggs with a lower temperature. You could use things like coconut oil, or you could cook without oils. So if you're a bodybuilder or if you're trying to lose weight, for example, you might want to poach or boil your eggs rather than cooking them all in oil. And one egg is only about 75 calories. They are the ultimate diet food for late night snacking for me. That's just me. Now here's a tip. Should you be like Rocky and chug those raw eggs? So a myth is, raw eggs are more nutritious than cooked eggs. The fact is, while raw eggs are safe to consume in certain preparations like eggnogs, cooking eggs can improve their digestion and decrease the risk of foodborne illnesses like salmonella. Are eggs bad for heart health? Absolutely not. Even though they have cholesterol and saturated fat, these are not associated with heart disease. And the people who initially said eggs were unhealthy and fats were unhealthy, they had associations to the big food industry. They got a lot of money. There's a lot of accusations of improper behavior there. So there's really nothing that should tell you that they're unhealthy. Hey, guess what? We have a phenomenal book. I believe this is the premier book on chronic nerve pain and peripheral neuropathy pain on the planet. I've put years of work seeing tens of thousands of peripheral neuropathy patients, working with some of the best diabetic endocrinologists, the best doctors, the best neurologists, in building out this book. For you, my viewers, we have a discount code available. Get on our mailing list and get that book down here.